Before Danish merchants ever set foot in China, Danish royalty staged itself in the company of foreign peoples. Inspired by tales and artifacts from the Far East, they created for themselves a fantastical theater. This was the magical, imaginative world constructed at Rosenborg Castle in 1663 by King Frederick III. He used it as a secret audience chamber to entertain foreign diplomats. In the 1700s, prior to establishing trade with China, porcelain figurines still found their way to Denmark, where the Danes artistically constructed the world from whence they believed these figures had come. Watched over by Neptune, god of the seas, and Mercury, god of trade, the Danes set up the Danish Asiatic Company in order to sail to China. This adventure was motivated not by cultural curiosity, but from the compelling desire for money. Direct exchange with China could have resulted in more accurate representations of the country. Yet, imagination was far more intoxicating than reality. The trading company brought increasingly intricate pieces of porcelain, which could be held by the fingertips and turned to reveal strange new images that sent the royal mind careening off with the galleons destined for the Far East. This room of opulent exoticism in Frederiksberg Castle was a no more realistic representation of China than Rosenborg's pre-trade creations. The invention of new images arose from wondrous objects, traveling from craftsmen to porcelain pots to merchants to wall panels more outlandish at each turn, creating an exotic stage based on an imaginative aesthetic. The Danish royalty attempted to navigate two irreconcilable desires: to possess what the East had to offer and to perpetuate their self-made fantasy. Pursuing the profits of trade while enjoying a strange, alternate reality enabled the Danish royalty to dismiss information, yet pursue wonder in its purest form.